It's a New Year's Day edition of Hockey Night in New England, presented by Berkshire Bank, the official bank of Nesson's Boston Bruins coverage. It comes your way live from the Hub on Causeway and TD Garden, where the Bruins ring in the new year by hosting the Buffalo Sabres. And hello again, everybody. High above the ice, alongside Andy Brickley with Sophie Yerkstevich. I'm Jack Edwards. Happy New Year. Brick, if I were to sum up the previous games played in this season, in one word, it would be... don't ask me to spell that. But if you had your druthers, would you rather be playing your third game in 3.5 days, the Buffalo Sabres, or your first game in 16 days, the Boston Bruins?
Advantage Boston, as far as I'm concerned, Jack. You know, it's difficult when you come off any kind of break and have to play three that quickly if you're the Buffalo Sabres, particularly if you have so much doubt, like the Buffalo Sabres, and their ability to win hockey games. Boston, okay, a long layoff. Yeah, that could lead to a little bit of rust, but not in my mind. You know, they've had the opportunity to get everybody pretty much out of protocol, everybody healthy. They got a full roster. They've practiced 5 out of the last 6 days together as a team. They should be ready to execute here this afternoon.
So, Bruce Cassidy, humble as they come as a coach, has mixed things up. It's no reflection on any individual, especially Charlie Coyle, one of the few forwards who's performed at or above expectations. It's about chemistry.
And it's about offense, Jack. And the Bruins are looking for more offense outside of what used to be that top line of Marchand, Bergeron, and Pastrnak. Here's what you're going to get here this afternoon. Here's your lineup changes. We're going to focus on that second line. Second line center. It's been a missing element of the Boston Bruins in their top six. Today, you're going to have Eric Haller, who's played well lately ever since being a healthy scratch. Skating game, able to score a little bit, create plays, use his speed, be a more impactful player. He's got speed on the outside with Hall and Pastrnak. Both are goal scorers. Both need to score more than they've been scoring. So this will be that second line. They need to score off the rush. They need to have at least some kind of cycle game in the offensive zone. And don't give up the defensive aspect of the game. Eric Haller needs to do the job as that second-line center. And to your point, Charlie Coyle, much better, much more suited to be that third-line center.
That's the natural position, according to Bruce Cassidy. So the Bruins take on the defensively porous Buffalo Sabres with a new look on offense. The Bees and the Sabres were back in a flash. Mandatory policy at TD Garden has not affected the volume of the crowd. Today's starting goaltenders brought to you by Jordan's Furniture, not just a store, an experience. Ukko-Pekka Luukkonen was the Sabres' third pick, second round in the 2017 NHL draft. They are really impressed with his progress. Linus Ullmark, the ex-Saber, has a win already against his former team. Head coach Don Granato got off the COVID list after 5 days on it. He missed 2 games. The game is on. The Bruins playing their first game in 16 days. Alex Tuch steals. Matt Grizzlick tumbles in the corner. Tuch shoves the puck along, and the Bruins are going to go on the power play 13 seconds into the game.
Buffalo penalty 89, minor penalty for Crosby.
This starts with a turnover by Matt Grizzlick. He tried to force a play through the neutral zone, middle of the ice. Quick re-entry by the Buffalo Sabres after the steal. And then when Grizzly goes to the corner, you know, they're really trying to crack down on the cross-checking this year, Jack. That looked more like just a shove.
Yeah.
But it goes in Boston's favor. Power play for Boston. A power play stats are presented by Granite City Electric. Get on board with the GC Night Train exclusively from Granite City Electric.
Henry Jukiharju scales the puck the length of the ice. Charlie McAvoy will start out. Marchand racing up the left side. Gains the line past Nick Foligno. Pasternak tries to swipe it past Oppolzo. Kyle Oppolzo goes down and takes Bergeron down with him. Meanwhile, McAvoy past the hash marks. Marchand looking for his shot. It's not there. Low to Foligno. Back to Marchand. McAvoy taps back to Marchand. The seam pass. Foligno can't bunt the Pasternak feed in. Great work. Precise passing. Everything but the finish. Pasternak gains the line, tosses it over Asplund's stick, and Rasmus Asplund spanks it.
Yeah, pretty stationary penalty killing by the Sabres in that sequence, Jack. The Bruins probably had three, maybe four opportunities, whichever shot they wanted to take.
Charlie Coyle to Craig Smith. Coyle strides into the corner. Hall around to DeBrusque. Grizzlick backpedals. Jake DeBrusque looking for the shot. John Hayden blocks that. Grizzlick to Hall. Low for DeBrusque. Comes out the near side. Asplund staying in the house. Yielding the perimeter. Hall's shot. A save by Luukkonen.
Now, second power play unit. They're looking for Taylor Hall, who's going to come out towards the blue line in order to start arcing in the direction of the net. This is a play that the first unit, they had a couple of different opportunities to move that puck. Foligno looking for his first of the year. That nice little redirect on the feet from Pasternak just off the outside post. Get a good look at it from the overhead. And then that second unit follows up where Grizzlick finds Taylor Hall on that little arc play, Jack, out by the blue line where he's attacking in a shooting position.
Grizzlick catch and release. Can't connect with Smith. Mark Pesek around to Tage Thompson, and he scoots it the length of the ice. I spent part of the break studying Pittsburgh's best in the league penalty kill. The Buffalo penalty kill is the opposite of that. Buffalo tends to protect the house and yield 15 feet or more along the perimeter, offering up the chance to shoot. Nolsik, the shot, and a glove stop by Luukkonen, whereas Pittsburgh, you have a tenth of a second before somebody's on you.
Yeah, if you're going to beat him and you're going to score on him, you got to move the puck. It's got to be accurate. It's got to be quick, and you can't play stationary because they're going to force. It all depends on your philosophy and the skill set of your penalty killers that will determine the best way to kill penalties.
Bruins managed a couple of shots during their man advantage. Rasmus Dahlin to Henry Jokiharju, both first-round draft choices. Dahlin, of course, number one in his entry year. Nolsik denied by Luukkonen, point blank. The Bruins have had a couple of close calls already in the first three-plus minutes of this game.
Yeah, Nolsik got two on this shift alone.
Kyle Oppolso taps to Casey Fitzgerald from North Reading, Massachusetts. And BC. Yes, he is the son of ex-Bruin and former Nashville captain Tom Fitzgerald, who is now the GM of a burgeoning New Jersey team. Derek Forbert taps the backhand. Bounces off Pasternak. Pesek, the defenseman. Forbert chops down on him. Frees the puck. Barakola pursued by Brett Murray. Murray is a monster. 6'5", 228. And he uses his body. He's not afraid to drop the mitts either. Pesek in front. Ethan Prowl, who's played just a couple of NHL games. A career journeyman, Dahlin. Puck pinballs around and John Hayden comes up with it. Makes a move at the line, which sends two teammates offside.
We talked about the need for more offense from this Bruins team as we enter this reset portion of the season. We showed you the Foligno chance on the power play. He hit the post. This is the second opportunity for Tomasz Noszczyk. First one, he came arcing off the wall. Good wrist shot, glove save by UPL. And then that opportunity in tight. He tried to go blocker side.
Jeff Skinner glides in to lose the faceoff to Bergeron. No shame in that. Bergeron continues to lead the league in faceoff win percentage. Matt Grizzly swivels to Bergeron. Marchand turns away from the huge Thompson. Bergeron gets, Marchand gets the tap, and McAvoy gets denied. Buffalo ices the puck, and it'll come back to Luukkonen's end. He has been busy.
Now, this is one of the things that Brad Marchand does probably better than anybody in the National Hockey League. There's a lot of good players that retrieve pucks in this league, but at his size, but his conditioning, his strength, and his want for the puck, it's just so impressive. You know, he had to make that little inside-outside move for early possession going down the wall, and then the puck's up for grabs in the slot. He stays with it, and he sets up McAvoy for a grade-A chance to try to go short side high.
Jeff Skinner winds up, and Omar denies him. Butcher shot well wide. Paula can't control the puck. Pasternak steals from Skinner. Carlo through the center circle and no icing. Pasternak's pursuit of the puck against Pesek pays off. Coyle, Butcher, Forbert steals after the check. Clifton takes it away from Peyton Krebs, only to give it up again. Krebs was a key part of the Vegas steal that made Jack Eichel property of the Golden Knights. Prowl flips it forward. Krebs, nice catch out of the air by Dahlin. He gets the puck deep. McAvoy floats it up. Coyle checked by Eakin. Brett Murray banks it. Dahlin gets it back. Eakin shot, or Hinostroza with his first touch off the COVID list, puts Buffalo up one zip.
I mean, this is a pretty good shot because he's backing away from the net in order to get open space in the high slot, but it doesn't appear to have a lot on it. It's a good quick release. The Bruins had an opportunity to get the puck into the neutral zone, failed to do it once, maybe twice. Nice little exchange. Good pickup by Murray up his skate, up to the blade of his stick in order to keep this play alive, and then makes a nice little pass into that high slot. Hinostroza is moving in the wrong direction in terms of attacking the net, but he catches, releases while backpedaling, and that may have changed direction, perhaps off Foligno, but it gets by Omar. Can the Sabres have the lead?
Hinostroza's sixth goal of the season. Joki Haru strides out of the Sabres zone. Anders Bjork, the ex-Bruin, deflected into the Boston bench. About 13 minutes to go, first period. Buffalo has drawn first blood. First goal of the game. Well, there you see the Atlantic Division standings. Bruins 3 points behind the Red Wings. They'll travel to Detroit tonight. Note the games played. The Bruins have at least one game in hand on every team in the league.
Now, the Bruins got some work to do if they're going to climb into the top three when you take a look at Tampa and Florida and Toronto. But yep, if you're going to focus on the Detroit Red Wings, Jack, the Bruins have a better winning percentage.
Yep.
You know, exactly what you're talking about with all those games in hand. So, huge game tomorrow. Certainly not looking past the Sabres, but a big game tomorrow up in Detroit.
Yep. Lazar and Asplund stalemate. John Hayden swivels. Yoki Haru to Dahlin, the one timer off the end glass. Asplund kicks it in front of the Zamboni doors. Lazar goes down, and we get a call and a scrum.
Yeah, this was a more of a cross check, I thought, than the call on Alex Tuck.
Yep.
And it should go against Anders Bjork, I believe. The referee out in the neutral zone certainly had his arm up after the cross check. I think Bjork's going to go. I think that'll be the only penalty minutes. Bjork from behind, defenseless players on the numbers. Certainly a penalty call there. Boston will have their second power play of the period.
Buffalo number 96, 2 minute minor boarding.
Okay, boarding.
Take your pick. Power play presented by Granite City Electric.
You know the importance of first goals in a game, and you hope that, you know, the numbers don't bear out today because the Bruins are down by one. But, you know, you think about the opportunities the Bruins had with that power play earlier in the period. Foligno off the post, but they had a number of easy looks with the man advantage. We talked about it in the pregame show, Jack. The power play has to be more of an effective weapon.
Pastrnak whips it back to McAvoy. Marchand kicks to the stick. McAvoy to Pastrnak. The one-timer leaves a dent in the corner boards and takes a lively 190-foot bounce. McAvoy feeds Marchand. Gains the slot, only to have the puck sticked away. Bergeron to McAvoy. Pastrnak looking for Bergeron, loose puck, and Dahlin makes a sprawling clear. Rasmus Asplund knocks it through center.
Yeah, I didn't know if that was Dahlin or Asplund that got to that loose puck before Marchand, but there was an opportunity because of a purposeful shot out high creating the rebound.
Pastrnak all the way to the corner, slings the puck around. Foligno pokes it forward. Pesek takes the puck away. McAvoy, the keep-in, takes the hit from Opozo. Hall feeds Foligno. Pastrnak backing up. Hall out of the corner finds McAvoy, the wrist shot. Foligno was felled in front of Luukkonen, but Luukkonen steered the puck to the end boards. Hall tries the seam pass off a stick and the clear by the Sabres. About a quarter of a minute to go in the man advantage. Luukkonen ladders it around. Craig Smith reverses. Matt Kryzlik speeds to the corner. Jake DeBrusk trying to get away from Prowl. Coyle feeds Hall back to Coyle. Skates. It takes a wacky bounce for Bjork. Two on one with Thompson. Bjork's shot. Partially blocked by Kryzlik to the
well defended. I mean, that's Kryzlik defended. He looked like he was just going to say, okay, Ullmark, you got the shooter, you got Bjork. And when Bjork waited a second too long, he got his stick in there. Not even a shot on goal.
Frederick breaks up the rush at the blue line. Olofsson down to the corner. Carlo takes the hit from Krebs. Mike Riley chips the puck forward to Frederick. He can't keep it on his backhand. Will Butcher. Frederick turns him back. Fitzgerald catch and release. Peyton Krebs wing to wing. Vinny Hinostrosa challenges Ullmark. Ullmark stayed big even though he was down. That's icing.
Go back to the Bruin power play, and Foligno's had a good start to this hockey game, working the front of the net. Bergeron's looking for the redirect. Foligno's in the blue paint. Rebound squirts out the other side. Marchand nearly gets there. Here's the two-on-one. Bjork right out of the penalty box. Kryzlik defended that perfectly. Center field, and then closes quickly just on the release by Bjork with good stick position.
Curtis Lazar, who once played for Buffalo, will butcher Fitzgerald's shot. Caroms off of Skinner, and Frederick ices it again. Signs of rust.
Yeah, that's what we said. I still believe advantage Boston, given the situation with the schedule and the Bruins' ability to get their full roster and practice some days together. I think that in the long run in this game should benefit Boston. But yeah, some rust early on. Tough to simulate game conditions and puck battles and so on in practice to do the best you can. So got to get used to the NHL again. But I expect Boston to really start to find their game. And, the game could have even already a different feel to it had Boston cashed in on a couple of those opportunities early.
Dahlin finds Skinner. Poke check by forward. Craig Smith pursuing the puck. Dahlin gets possession back for the Sabres. Tape to Skinner. He dumps it to the wall. Alex Tuck, who is a house, centers. And the puck deflects off Thompson's try near post. Ethan Prow. Mark Pesek. Brett Murray back to Prow. Off Hall's stick. Pasternak to Hall. The shot. A blocker saved by Luukkonen. All the way out beyond the blue line. Clifton clatters it off the corner glass. Ethan Prow reverses. Pesek off the boards to Hinostroza, wing to wing. Prow, the defenseman who led Rochester defenseman at the time of his call-up in points. Fitzgerald. Will Butcher, Hobie Baker Award winner in college, and the ex-New Jersey Devil. Fitzgerald, Oposo, the play is offside. Less than 8 minutes to go, first period. The Bruins getting their sea legs back. Vinny Hinostroza has Vinny Hinostroza's sixth goal had some help.
Yeah, Sabres on top 1-0 as a result. Good look at this shot and what happens to it. And you can see it off that left shin pad, right up around the knee of Foligno. And it's going to change direction. And if you focus on Hinostroza, he's moving away from the net. So that's why when we reacted to the goal, it didn't look like it had a lot on it. But it did change direction. And if you watch Omar, he's bracing to take that somewhere off his midsection. Now it changes direction. Blocker side, finds an opening.
Buffalo controls the draw. Will Butcher scales it around. Riley frees the puck. Peyton Krebs pokes it to the corner. Tape to tape pass from Oposo to the wrong color sweater. Coyle. DeBrusque off Fitzgerald's stick. Oposo nudges to Fitzgerald. DeBrusque locks him up. Fitzgerald, a clever short pass through the seam. Peyton Krebs, Kyle Oposo ramps up off Riley's stick and out of play.
Tomorrow at noon, join Dale and Billy for Bruins Face Off Live, presented by EchoStar Technologies. They'll have an in-depth preview of the matchup with the Red Wings and all the latest NHL news. EchoStar Technologies, vision, strategy, success.
Bruins will play basically every other day until the end of April. Every 8 games, there will be an average of 24 hours additional time in there. But that is a burnout schedule. And it's even more dense than a long playoff run. So the depth of Boston is going to be tested. Connor Clifton waves it forward. Clifton gets pinned in by Murray. Forward shot well wide. Frederick Lazar against Yoki Haru. Cody Eakin whirls it free. Forward pinching down, depriving the Sabres of the exit. Dahlin with Marchand closing. Dahlin flips it past Craig Smith. It bounces past Clifton as well. Forward feeds Smith. Short pass too far forward for Bergeron. Prowl center circle. Skinner deflects to Tuck. Thompson sweeps it through both corners. Craig Smith laterally. Marchand to Bergeron to Marchand for Smith. A good move by Luukkonen quickly across the goal line. Less than 6 minutes to go, first period. Bruins looking for the equalizer.
Garden, for those of you who have tickets to the January 18th game at TD Garden versus the Carolina Hurricanes, are in for a treat, because that is when the Boston Bruins are going to honor the great Willie O'Ree and retire his number 22 jersey into the rafters. He becomes the 12th Bruin to have his number retired, and of course was the first black player to play in an NHL game when he suited up for the Bruins against the Montreal Canadiens. That was on January 18th, 64 years ago this coming year. And since then, as you guys know, he's done so much for the game and continues to do for the game of hockey.
Marchand crashing the net, keeping the puck alive. Bergeron banks the pass. Grizzlick, a nice catch of a tumbling puck. Hayden clubs it off the boards. Craig Smith to Bergeron, kicks to the stick off the corner boards. The puck bouncing around. Asplin leaves it for Dahlin. Looks to the attacking line. Bjork steps back, and the play is offside.
Was it really offside?
Well, the whistle blew. I was assuming. You know how you spell assume, right?
Yeah, I mean, Bjork was in the offensive zone with both skates, but the puck never even got to the blue line.
Right.
Well, whatever. Just to follow up on what Sophia just reported on, you know, the January 18th celebration of Willie O'Ree. Today, January 1st, 1961, Willie O'Ree scored his first goal in the National Hockey League against those Montreal Canadiens.
And we're going to rub it in. Great man. His number will go right up between Nifty's and Harris Arapola. Nifty's and Terry O'Reilly's. Carlo's drive and a glove save by Luukkonen.
More opportunities for Boston. Turnover by the Sabres. They brought it back into their own zone, so the play was onside. And Eric Hall is able to walk in from the top of the circle. He's on his backhand. And he's going to miss the net. And then the follow-up, again, a nice play by the Bruins in the offensive zone. And they use their defense. Here's the pass for Pastrnak after the turnover. Self-inflicted by the Sabres. Kahlo drifted one on the follow-up, tried to go glove side. I think he was actually looking for Haller as well. Maybe get a little redirect on that drive.
Now that the Bruins have worked up a lather, they seem to be playing really much better. Marchand tried to dance around Yoki Haru. Great reach around by Smith to Rob Tuck. Smith barrels through Tuck again. Smith wide on the shot. What a shift. Everything but the finish. Tage Thompson, all 6-7 of him, gives to Skinner. A save by Omark. That was a huge save. Tage Thompson has blossomed and how this season.
Yeah, he's their top guy really right now in terms of offense. And what a move, inside, outside. Good speed. You know, Forbert's a big guy with a long reach. He doesn't get the poke check. Now he's at a severe disadvantage. And how about that little back diagonal pass? Catch and release by Skinner. He tries to go blocker side. This is the save of the period right here. Omar keeps this a 1-0 game.
Eakin and Coyle on the drop. Foligno nudges to Clifton. Off the boards to DeBrusk. Spoons it down the slot. And Estroza and DeBrusk on the boards. Foligno, the puck deflects out of play.
And a random thought, I wanted to go back to this when you were talking about that deep dive you did on the penalty killing by Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
You know, we talked about how aggressive they are, and if you're going to beat them, you have to beat them a certain way. But the other thing, too, about penalty killing, Tristan Jarry.
Yeah.
He's having a pretty good year down there in Pittsburgh.
Who does he think he is, Matt Murray?
We talk about goaltenders being your best penalty killers. He's had a terrific year, and what the Penguins have been able to do with all their injuries and absences in their lineup, the COVID. Tremendous job by Mike Sullivan to keep that team right where they are in the standing.
I was going to say, pretty good coach. Riley's shot, a long rebound off Luukkonen's leg save. Bruins want Riley to shoot more, to be the player he was when he got to Boston in trade last year. Pass ready and shot ready are the components of the thumbnail sketch on Mike Riley. Bruins Rock, presented by Plymouth Rock, the official auto insurance program of the Boston Bruins. Eric Halla averaging less than 15 minutes of time on ice. Sands to boost that average if he continues to play second line minutes. Vinastroza through Asplund's stick. Foligno, who hit a post. The backhand hurled over the goal. Ethan Prow in trouble in the corner as the Bruins go on the forecheck. Foligno back to forward. Coyle can't get through to the corner. Anders Bjork. Foligno whacks the puck away.
Now, the Bruins don't have anything to show for it, Jack, but Buffalo has turned the puck over a ton here the second half of this period.
Clifton off Butcher's stick and out of play. Yeah, the thing we were noticing when video scouting the Sabres is they play like a young team. They're impatient with the puck. And for instance, John Hayden ate the puck in the attacking zone, and it stood out because he was patient. And, you know, if it's not there, eat the puck, find a teammate, fight another day. Don't try to force it through a seam.
Yeah, and you can be, tolerant of that, I don't know what you want to call it, impatience in the offensive zone. But breaking the puck out, I mean, hey, if you got to be methodical at times to protect the puck and not turn it over, then be methodical.
Right. Opozo loses his stick on contact with Carlo. Riley to Marchand. Pivots away from Krebs. Bergeron's long shot blocked over the netting. And a souvenir for a fan in the ninth row. Bergeron to Marchand. Thompson. I'll go back to what you said years ago, Brick. Tall players, you got to be patient. They're late bloomers. McAvoy's drive. Luukkonen, 6 feet outside his crease, wondered where the puck was, but it was stuck in his pads after he broke down the angle. And how?
Yeah, Bruins about a half a dozen times in this period have been able to use that low to high game. It's a nice little feet saucer pass from the corner of the rink. Good pass by Noshik after the forced turnover again. And good call, Jack. Goaltender for Buffalo. Look where he is. You can't see net. If you're Charlie McAvoy, you can't see net in that situation. You got a big body, fully padded, coming out outside the blue paint. It's difficult to find an opening.
Coyle and Aiken. Coyle wins the drop. DeBrusk to Riley, the drive off the end glass. Pesek yields to Eakin. Pesek finds Hinostroza. Back to Pesek. Cracks it through both corners. Eakin on it. DeBrusk. Final minute of play in the first period. Vinny Hinostroza's goal has Buffalo up 1-0. Brett Murray off the boards. McAvoy, good body position. And Pastrnak offside. Just by that much.
Yeah, a stride earlier maybe by McAvoy, and Pastrnak doesn't have to try to make this onside play. And it just got deflected a little bit by Darlene. Maybe slowed it down just a hair to cause Pastrnak to have to do what he did. Looked like he had contact with that blue line with his left skate.
Wow.
But the linesman made the offside call, and I'm not sure Pastrnak would have been in alone because he had to do some gymnastics to stay onside.
The Bruins would have rolled the dice on that one gladly. Paul. In the corner, shielding from Dahlin. McAvoy to Krizlik, catch and release. And again, Lukanen scoops it up off the ice.
Again, that low to high has been effective here for Boston. And it's a nice little play over to the elbow. There's your pass from McAvoy. The quick little shot, looking for a redirect, maybe a rebound opportunity. Hey, maybe it has eyes and finds the back of the net. Paula just couldn't get free from his check to get a piece of it.
Asplund spins the puck to the corner. And John Hayden deflects it into the bench.
Stay with us after the game for Bruins postgame final presented by Rodenheiser Home Services. Get in-depth insights on what's ahead for the black and gold. Stay in the know all season long with Bruins postgame final.
The league average points percentage when scoring first is 737. Buffalo, when scoring first, is at 571, ranked 27th out of 32. Bjork can't hurl it free of the blue line. Final seconds, Hayden over the spoke B, and the siren sounds to end the first. The Bruins spent most of the first 20 minutes apparently getting the rust off.
Yeah, I'm going to take the half glass full, Jack. I liked a lot of what Boston did. Could their execution been sharper? Absolutely, particularly in the first 10 minutes of that period. You like to get those early power plays, especially if you're going to score goals. Unable to do that. That lack of finish, something that's bothered this team all season long. They got to find a way to generate more goals. That's what we'll be looking for in period two.
It's only the fifth time in 33 games that Buffalo has led. Jack Edwards coming your way live from TD Garden, where the Sabres lead the Bruins. One zip heading to the second period. Brick, you know that I appreciate people who give it to you straight. So here's Sophie Yurkshevich with a story about Brad Marchand.
Jack, you took the words right out of my mouth because I was going to say Brad Marchand tells it like it is, and he told us that he was beyond frustrated about the NHL's decision to not let their players head to the Olympics because of COVID-related complications and issues. Now, he said that this is something that every kid dreams of, representing their country at the Olympics, and we know at 33 years old, one, his window might be closing, but also that his hockey has gotten better with age, and he said this is something that he really was working towards and wanted to have that chance. He wanted the NHL to let players decide with their families if they wanted to go. And he also said the NHLPA isn't off the hook. He feels like they didn't fight well enough for their players like him, other teammates of his on the Bruins, and even Patrice Bergeron, who's been to two Olympics already, said that despite the risks, he considered it with his family and said he would have chosen to go. So obviously, as fans, my heart and our heart breaks out for these guys who may not have another chance to represent their country in the Olympics, but hopefully they can can concentrate on winning some hardware here this season with the Boston Bruins, guys.
Thanks, Sophia. Second period underway. Almost. And now it is. Brick, you wore the national team sweater and were a player rep. I would be inquisitive about your position on this automatic decision.
Yeah, it's definitely worthy of a conversation, and obviously not an opportunity during game action to discuss it at length because that's what's required.
Marchand tripped from behind by Skinner, and the Bruins would go on the power play for the third time.
Well, easy entry. I mean, that's just too easy for the Buffalo Sabres to allow Brad Marchand to carry the puck. But
Buffalo minor number 53, 2 minutes.
And when people are driving through the middle of the ice, that's what it allows you to do as the puck carrier. Delay, look for options. Skinner in the box for the stick work. Bruins back on the power play. But, yeah, I definitely have opinions because I was on the fast track for the 84 Olympic team, Jack. And I had to make a decision as to, you know, in those days, NHL players certainly didn't play in the Olympics.
Yep. Marchand fans, Eakin clears. The Bruins power play brought to you by PNC Bank, helping to make banking easier. Marchand swivels across the line. McAvoy as Hayden collects his stick. Bergeron to Foligno. Puck comes off his forehand, cruising the slot. Pasternak duffs a forehand. Bergeron rescues the puck around to Marchand. Feathers the pass back to Pasternak. Fires on Luukkonen, and Foligno on the tip. Or a tip attempt. Marchand to Foligno off the post again. The guy is snake bitten today. Foligno, good effort. Marchand. Foligno tries to jam it. And the no call, no goal call from Brad Meyer immediately.
Well, you got to battle the frustration if you're Foligno because he's had a good game. He's had a good game. Here's a nice chance on the shot by Pasternak. Can't get the redirect. Gets body position. There's a redirect. There's your second chance opportunity. Bats it out of midair. Just misses short side. There's a nice redirect off the side of the net on the second chance. He's right where he should be. He's making the plays he's supposed to make. Hit the post on a redirect back in the first period, early in the first period on the power play. And to add to the frustration, the only goal of the game deflected in off him.
Omar flattens the puck for Matt Grizzlick. Drops it off for Taylor Hall. Hall to DeBrusk over the line. Back to Hall across the front. Dahlin blocks the centering pass. Smith to Hall. Cuts off the half boards. DeBrusk on the second try off Smith's shot. And Buffalo clear.
Now that all starts with a nice delay on the breakout. It allows Taylor Hall to generate speed through center ice. That gets entry. Smith with a good keeping on the right wing boards. They get a couple of real good looks.
Smith banks the pass to Coyle. Hall closes. Drops it back to the blue line. Five on five. Grizzlick's shot tipped through the slot. Coyle jams it right through the goal mouth. Riley fresh off the Boston bench. The puck gets out into the neutral zone.
They got a little unlucky. You know, he good hustle to get to that puck, and he just tried a one-handed to keep it in the offensive zone.
Tage Thompson, the back foot snapshot. And he got some mustard on that one.
Yeah, there's some giddy up on that release. We'll go back to this delay. Grizzlick off the boards, indirect. Allows Taylor Hall to generate speed here. Throws off the timing of the penalty kills. Oposo's not going to deny him. Nice little curl and drag play by DeBrusk to go right back to Hall to keep it by Smith. And then Smith gets open in the slot for a good catch and release. And then DeBrusk get a rebound chance on the backhand.
Riley nudges to Lazar. The backhand to Halla. Nosek pressuring Butcher. Butcher goes down. Riley spanks it around through both corners. Carlo, a good read. Lazar's shot. Lukanen steers the rebound to the boards. Riley around through the corner. Lazar, butcher's check, bears him off. Here's Vinny Iniestrosa through the goal mouth. Milsik to Lazar. Riley's shot lands in the trapper of Ukko-Pekka Luukkonen.
What if the level of service your bank provided wasn't based on the cash you have? What if the only thing in your wallet that mattered to us was you? Come bank at a place where all wallets are welcome. Berkshire Bank, member FDIC.
The Bergeron line out there. If you're joining us late and you haven't been keeping current on Bruins news, Craig Smith flipping with David Pastrnak as Bruce Cassidy juggles the lines. Marchand, McAvoy, Marchand's one-timer loose in front, and Smith scores a great dirty goal. That's what Bruce Cassidy is describing when he says inside ice.
And Safina talked to Craig Smith between periods, and one of the points he made was what? Well, you love playing with Bergeron because he wins a lot of face-offs. So you play with the puck a lot. And Bergeron wins the draw in the offensive zone. Nice clean on the back end. Good decision by Marchand to use McAvoy. They set up the two-on-one out high for the one-timer from Marchand. And if you don't score from there, what are you trying to do? Generate a rebound. And the Bruins get to the goal-scoring areas. You know, Cam Neely talks about greasy goals. We'll put that in that category.
Yeah.
Hard-nosed play. Craig Smith made a living in that part of the ice. Buries one.
Bruins' goal was brought to you by Audi. Iniestrosa across the defensive zone. Rasmus Dahlin spoons it forward. Dahlin played 12 minutes, 7 seconds in the first 20 minutes of the game. Glides over the line, flips it to the end boards, engages Dahlin. A penalty coming, and it's going to be a hold on Holla, and he protests.
Yeah, I think they're going to call hold the stick. Could be wrong, but that's what it looked
Brandon
like.
Brandon Schrader on the call.
Boston number 56, 2 minutes, holding the stick.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got to look at it there. Maybe a little bit of the grab, maybe a little bit of the chicken wing on Dahlin in that one-on-one battle. Hall didn't like the call. Hall got in there, and good support, too. It had a nice wraparound back to the right point, but obviously the play whistled down for the penalty to Boston.
Bruins have allowed power play goals in 5 consecutive games. Carlo with a bowling check. And Marchand clears the puck. Buffalo 0-5 in the season series in 2 previous meetings. Jeff Skinner swivels, forward, second effort, can't glove it out of the zone. Peyton Krebs to Rasmus Dahlin. Tage Thompson plays catch, gets it back. Alex Tuck, catch and release. Thompson to Tuck, to Skinner, behind the back. Krebs feeds it through the crease, off Carlo's skate, I believe. And Dahlin can't keep it in. Good poke check by Tomas Nelsik. Alex Tuck. Dahlin. Nelsik attacks the puck.
It's another
and it's going to be about 3/4 of a minute of 5-on-3.
Nelsik out high in the
Boston
defensive
Myers,
zone.
Number 92, 2 minutes for tripping.
Looked like he lost an edge initially when he was attacking Dahlin. And then when he got himself back up into the play, had that long reach with the stick. And I believe it was Krebs that went down on the play. Clearly a trip. 2-man advantage, Buffalo.
Timeout, Buffalo.
Buffalo's going to use this opportunity, Jack, to talk it over. Make sure that their top offensive power play unit is well rested. They understand the importance of this juncture of the hockey game, this amount of time, and a 5-on-3, a goal or two here really could change the complexion of this one.
Nolcik in the box for 2 minutes and 46 seconds left on Hollins.
Yeah, good use of their version of the bumper. It was Skinner that took that little feed from below the goal line, I believe, from Tuck. He went behind his back. Krebs was creeping in. Just missed on that backdoor connection. But now Boston will be taxed at a 5-on-3. This requires patience. You can't be overly aggressive. You got to get to rebounds. You got to have good body and stick position.
Bergeron wins the draw. Carlos Gates passed it. Tuck back to the point. Dahlin to Olofsson. Olofsson's a sniper. He's got the puck on his blade. Missed stick handles. Forbert can't come up with it. Tage Thompson. Dahlin tries to draw Bergeron. Olofsson. Dahlin. Olofsson looks for an opening. Forbert got a piece. Carlo to the corner. Forbert the next layer and hoists the snow over the drift. Hollows out. Saved by Olmark. Thompson. Dahlin. Forward won't bite. Olofsson to Skinner. The drive on a blocker saved by Olmark. The puck bounding along the dasher. Here's Olofsson. Wide on the stick side. Butcher. The one-timer Thompson. A good move by Olmark. But the Bruins can't clear. About a half a minute to go in the man advantage for Buffalo. Butcher to Olofsson. Will Butcher's wrist shot misses wide and high.
Behind.
Paula. Whoa, drills it off Olofsson's skates.
Now, Buffalo's 5-on-4, far more effective than their 5-on-3. They used their timeout to talk about what they wanted to do on the 5-on-3, and they, I don't know if it was just indecision or too much time and space. Not effective.
Krebs into the middle. Murray going for the tip. 5-on-5 now as Nosek's out of the box and he breaks free with DeBrusque. Lazar the trailer. Lazar goes into the right wing corner. Nosek into Clifton skates. Cliffy can't pull it off. Peyton Krebs pulls up, finds a Pozo, closing the shot, a save by Olmark. About 12 minutes to go, second period, 1-1 at TD Garden. At Bernie and Phil's, get the furniture you want and save up to 20% during their holiday savings event. The NHL making consideration for the fan banishment in Canada currently has moved the March 21st game to January 12th against the Canadiens. So if you have tickets for the March 21st Canadiens game at TD Garden, use them on the 12th of January. Kinestroza off a stick. McAvoy closes. Kinestroza beats Eakin. Casey Fitzgerald along the line. Butcher's shot off McAvoy off the end boards. Bjork keeps it alive. Kinestroza turns and fires off a stick. Butcher tries to feed it front. Eakin gathers the puck. Bjork belts it around and past Fitzgerald. Bergeron line gets off the ice without getting the puck out of the defensive zone. Butcher off the boards. Hayden couldn't find the puck. The linesman cowboying up on the dasher. Carlo. Riley. Wrists it forward to Hall. Hall spins out of the top of the slot. Pastrnak going one on two. Brett Murray can't clear the zone. Carlo sticks a fork in the puck. Hall back to Riley. To Carlo. Looking for the seam pass to Pastrnak. Prow knocks it to Rasmus Asplund, and Buffalo clears. Riley feeds DeBrusk, the backhand, a save by Luukkonen, and Prow goes barreling into the post, dislodging the net.
Great look by Mike Riley. He's having a strong game. He's right on top of it. Nice saucer pass through the middle to wide open DeBrusk. DeBrusk on his attempt to attack the net, kind of lost an edge a little bit, lost some of his momentum on that little balance. Still gets a pretty good opportunity away, trying to get his own rebound. Prow goes flying into the net. But a nice look by Riley, who defended nicely on Murray initially to get the puck, and then a quick up because he knew Buffalo at least wanted to make a partial change.
Jokke Harju behind his own goal. Alex Tuck off the boards. McAvoy tears it away from Skinner. DeBrusk elevates the pass. Cross ice. Jokke Harju swings at it. Dahlin can't get it out of the zone. DeBrusk, good body position in front to Foligno. Tries to kick to the stick, but he's wearing Tage Thompson. All 6-7 of him. DeBrusk back to McAvoy. Draws Tuck. Tuck taps the puck away. DeBrusk rescues it. Krebs on it. And Jokke Harju has the puck behind the red line. Marchand dislodges it. Craig Smith wing to wing as the Bruins scramble not to get a too many men on the ice.
Yeah, I was chuckling at the fact that, Bruins did a nice job of getting this puck down right here below us on the left wing side of the ice. And then Charlie Coyle was over by the Bruin bench. You know, he was hanging around a little bit on the back check until he saw Bruins get possession. Now he wants to make a change. Just as he's putting his leg over the boards, Craig Smith tried to pass it to him.
Pesek's shot, an easy glove save for Linus Ullmark. About 9 minutes to go, second period. Bruins and Sabres deadlocked at TD Garden. Hit yourvaccine.com to find out where to get your booster shot.
Yeah, we're going to focus on Craig Smith right off this faceoff. When Marchand and McAvoy do their thing, it's just all about getting inside position at the top of the blue paint. And the Sabres want nothing to do with them. Dahlin ended up on the side of the net, and Craig Smith was in the goal-scoring position.
Fitzgerald. Skinner turns to face the goal. Swivels on the boards. Fitzgerald along the line. Butcher's wrist shot through a screen. Skinner tosses the puck to Butcher. Fitzgerald through the seam. Intended for Skinner. Thompson right up the slot. Tuck turn around. Skinner picks up the garbage and beats Ullmark. 2-1 Buffalo.
Yeah, just a sloppy shift by Boston, Jack. You know, it's like they were allowing Buffalo to get to pucks, allowing them to just, you know, play that low to high, back to the low game, and then not forcing people. The puck deflects right to Marchand. He can't handle it. Bruins can't corral the puck. They can't get to it. A little too stationary and a lot of motion by the Sabres, and they got some puck luck. The puck finds them, but Skinner, a good goal scorer. He gets an opportunity from that close. He's going to share his, he's going to score his share of goals, and that's a nice wrist shot from in tight inside the dot. It beats Ullmark to reestablish the one-goal lead for Buff.
Dahlin threw a stick. Brett Murray paddles it down. Clifton to Forbert. Plenty of time and room. Banks the pass to Pastrnak. The drop to Holla. Pastrnak swivels to the backhand. Cody Eakin has made his mark as an NHL player defending like that. Brett Murray. Krebs misses stick side. Hinostroza across ice. Murray into the middle. Clifton makes the play. Holla lobs the puck. Pesek takes it down. Forbert trying to nurse an icing call. The linesman not buying it. Victor Olsson in the corner. Reverses, Peyton Krebs at the hash marks, finds it again, over to Pesek, tipped on the way through. The catch and release, Olofsson bounds back to Prow, tape to tape, Pesek's drive off of Pozo in front. Prow, good attacking zone time for Buffalo, the Bruins having trouble in the second period.
Bruins needed a whistle. I mean, that defensive pair, I'm not sure how long the shift was, but they looked gassed, particularly Forbert. You pointed it out, Jack, you know, laboring to get to that puck. I don't think he was trying to milk it to get an icing. I think he was spent.
Maybe.
And DeBrusque was the only one that really had any juice because he was the freshest. He came out on a one-man line change. And that allowed the Sabres to have all kinds of energy and puck possession. Offensive zone time.
Curtis Lazar in his second shift after going down the tunnel briefly. Will Butcher's wrist shot blocked by Nosek, I believe. Fitzgerald to Asplund. The drop pass comes all the way through. Butcher. Lazar takes him out. Nosek to Frederick. He floats the wrist shot over the goal. Lazar cross corner. Nosek fighting off Butcher. Hayden tosses to the blue line. Good keep in by Carlo, and it's a hand pass. 6:19. Left to go, second period.
Switch to Arbella. Combine your home and auto insurance to save 20% or more. Arbella, here for Bruins fans, here for good.
Smith. Yoki Haru bunks it ahead. Tuck. Can't gain the line. Skinner does, but Thompson was inside.
All right, Bruins need a couple of back-to-back good shifts here to get this game back to where they wanted it. After the Craig Smith goal, you felt like the Bruins are starting to take over and find some rhythm to their offense and their game, and then they have a sloppy shift. They give up the Skinner goal. Now they got to get it generated again, going where they're the better team. Spend some time in the offensive end.
Marchand throws it past Dahlin. Marchand reverses, loses Thompson. Grizzlick's one-timer blocked. Thompson, the backhand into Tuck skates. Tuck wrestles down Bergeron, and the Bruins are gonna go on the power play again. Less than 6 minutes to go, second period. The Bruins with the man advantage and a chance to tie it when the game resumes.
Alex Tuck going to make his way to the penalty box for the second time here this afternoon. He gets locked up a little bit with Patrice Bergeron. He argued all the way to the penalty box, and from either angle, you can understand his frustration. Didn't look like there was much there, but he'll go to the box. Interference, the call. And Boston on the power play.
Didn't look like there was much there on the first infraction allegedly committed by Alex Tuck.
A little wrinkle change here by Boston on their man advantage. Charlie Coyle is going to get an opportunity to work the front of the net.
Yep. Nick Foligno has been there on this unit. Marchand backs it off the boards. Good effort by Kyle Opulso. Pasternak scoops the puck out of his crease. Bergeron. Trouble from Hayden. Coyle. McAvoy. Bergeron. Leg saved by Luukkonen. Marchand, Pasternak, McAvoy. Draws Asplund. Bergeron bumps it back to Marchand. Switches with McAvoy. Marchand saucers it. McAvoy to Pasternak off of Joki Haru and wide. And Joki Haru steals the centering feed. Asplund finishes dumping it in. About three quarters of a minute to go in the Boston power play. Taylor Hall feeds David Pasternak. Craig Smith back to Nick Foligno. Matt Grizzlick. Smith yields to Hall. Grizzlick to Hall. Tees it up. Dahlin the block. Foligno into the corner. Prow jabs it loose. Foligno keeps it alive. Smith back to Grizzlick. The wrist shot. And it's stuck in Lukanen's body.
First unit looking for Patrice Bergeron in the bumper. He's going to pull it off his right hip in order to get this shot through. He's going to spin off Pisik. Slide out a little bit. Get that quick little release. He knows it doesn't have to be hard. Get it to the net. Hopefully Coyle gets a second chance opportunity or a tip in. Sabres are able to collapse enough to get to that loose puck.
Final 10 seconds of the power play. Smith, Grizzlick, Riley off Skinner's stick. Thompson backhands all the way to the Boston zone. Tuck is out of the box after a two-shot Boston power play. Curtis Lazar. Joki Haru comes through and loosens the puck. Fitzgerald can't clear the zone. Riley in front. Lazar wide. Frederick Riley gets it through a stick. Lazar keeps it alive, but the Bruins have to retreat back to center. Riley hard around. Paula kicks the puck down to the end boards. Paula out there with Frederick and Lazar. As Bruce Cassidy searches for offense. Bruins have just 8 goals in their last 6 games, including this afternoon. Carlo to the end wall. Butcher flips it high off glass. Clifton. Nosek. Hall. Good keep in by Forbert, getting his chest in the way of the airborne deflected puck. Hall comes off the hash marks. A save by Luukkonen, and Buffalo clears it out of the slot. So Bruce Cassidy has flipped Paula and Nosek. Brad Marchand. The Bergeron line together for a moment. Craig Smith replacing Pasternak. A wide open goal for Connor Clifton, and he spiked it across the crease.
And a delayed penalty on Boston to boot. Wow. What a sequence. Not going in Boston's favor. After Marchand got that puck in the neutral zone to Bergeron, now the Bruins can score off the rush, you think. Good shot, good rebound, open net, Clifton. I know it's a tough angle, but there's still plenty of time and angle to score. Talk about the inability to finish. Classic case right there. As the puck came back in the opposite direction, Craig Smith will go to the box. At Buffalo, what an opportunity with a 2-1 lead, late period two, with a minute 35 to go, a power play chance, looking to extend their lead.
As we mentioned, the Bruins have given up power play goals in five consecutive games, the longest streak of giving up at least one power play to their opponents in the Bruce Cassidy era. And the longest streak by Boston since November of 2015. Nolcik makes sure of the clear. Clicking toward a minute to go, there is a 25 second lag between the game clock and the penalty time. Peyton Krebs swivels it back to Will Butcher. Krebs closes. Finds the seam. Saucer pass didn't land. Tage Thompson back to Krebs. Dangles around Riley. And Tuck finds the goal. Alex Tuck's first as a Sabre.
Yeah, his name's all over the score sheet today. Penalties, now a goal. Go back to the penalty on Craig Smith. There's the chance, Connor Clifton. They thought that Smith's stick, that may not even counted had Connor Clifton buried that goal because they called Smith for a hook on the goaltender. And these two players were two of the key players that came over in the deal for Jack Eichel. Krebs, first pick by Vegas. You thought he was running out of time and running out of room, but he knew exactly what he wanted to do. He pulled that puck forehand, backhand, down deep off the side of the net. He finds Alex Tuck wide open in the slot, and he buries it high on the blocker side.
Krebs, number 17 overall in the entry draft of 2019. So the Bruins, unless they score in the next half minute, are going to be down two with 20 minutes to go in their first game in 16 days. Jake DeBrusk, the self pass. Dahlin pins it to the boards. Coyle goes in, loosens it. DeBrusk stays on his feet. Grizzlick to Coyle. Coyle tries to center it to DeBrusk. John Hayden, Yale man. Olmark out to the red line, and the siren sounds. It's a steep hill to climb.
It is, Jack, and because the Bruins' inability to finish has put them in this position, penalty killing continues to be a bit of an issue for Boston, kind of in the middle of the pack when you talk about the National Hockey League and their rankings. But again, the timeliness of the mistakes or the lack of finish that have led to Boston losses this year are there again today through two periods.
Dalen, the high-strength steel play brought to you by your New England Chevy dealers. The most important thing is the puck.
Well, just you think about the Bruins and where they are in this hockey game right now, down 3-1. And how does that happen when Buffalo turned the puck over as much as they did, particularly in the first period? You know, just lack of execution on the breakout, some forced turnovers, some unforced turnovers. But the Bruins, nothing to show for it when those turnovers were either created or handed to them. So again, Jack, the lack of finish, the lack of the ability to do something when they create those turnovers into production, into goals, into leads, and force teams to play catch-up has now made this third period a bit of a challenge for Boston.
Well, the Bruins have a 5-8-1 record against teams currently in the playoff structure. They are 9-2-1 against teams not in the playoff structure, including Buffalo. They need these 2 points. Bergeron, Marchand, and Craig Smith to start the third period. Charlie McAvoy paired with Matt Grizzlick. The Tage Thompson line has been very effective. Skinner and Tuck, the wings, with a goal each. Tuck with an assist. Thompson with an assist as Luukkonen carries one aside. Thompson gets the puck deep. Ullmark stops it for Grizzlick. Tosses it to Marchand. Soft pass. Tuck intercepts. Bergeron goes down the slot. Grizzlick settles the bouncer. Smith wing to wing. Marchand gains the line. Bergeron in the middle. Marchand tosses the self pass, guns it on Luukkonen. Pasternak off the side of the goal. Alex Tuck blocked down by Marchand. A keep in. Pasternak rips it wide. Stick side. A convenient carom for Jeff Skinner to Peyton Krebs. Off the post. Skinner's follow. The Bruins dodge an early bullet in the third.
As did Buffalo. They turn the puck over again, and the Bruins with Pasternak with an opportunity.
Mike Riley in and out of Lukanen's glove. Krebs feeds a pulso. Fires in on Ullmark, and two Bruins go for a slide.
Again, the turnover by Buffalo leads to this Pasternak chance. He misses wide, and that's to Skinner's benefit. Fresh ice. That puck's all the way out to the neutral zone. And even though the play is a broken play by Buffalo, Skinner's able to get to the puck first. It's about where he was when he attacked the net and scored in the second period. Gets a pretty good opportunity. Similar shot. This one catches iron.
Nolcik steers the puck back to forward. Pessing belts it off the boards. Hinostroza along the line. Wow, around the boards. Nolcik cross ice. Connor Clifton scoops it up. Trent Frederick skating just his ninth shift of the game.
Tomorrow, we're back with an original six matchup as the Bruins visit the Detroit Red Wings. We'll have pregame coverage beginning at noon and puck drop at 1 right here on Nesson. Presented by Verizon 5G. Built right.
Boyle, Foligno, and DeBrusque against the Asplund line. Hayden and Bjork, the wings. Jake DeBrusque scoops it. Fitzgerald knocks it down and oscillates the puck cross corner. Coyle. Forward. Off DeBrusque. The puck goes deep. Foligno ties up Butcher. Butcher squeaks it along through the corner. Clifton centers, and DeBrusque launches one over the glass.
Real nice pinch by Connor Clifton. Strong down the wall. He pushes the puck deep. Follows his own puck. Then he uses the net as his ally in order to create that little passing lane. DeBrusque wants to go up top with it. That puck just kind of on edge.
Yep.
DeBrusque tried to put it up under that crossbar. And just took off on him.
The Bergeron line with an attacking zone start. Bergeron wins the drop. Grizzlick's pass through Marchand. McAvoy one-hands it toward Grizzlick, draws it away from Hinostroza and Eakin. Craig Smith off the boards. Grizzlick can't pick it up. Rasmus Dahlin to Hinostroza. Brett Murray gets it deep. Omar. Grizzlick to Bergeron to Marchand. Stops on Jokiharju. Jokiharju belts it around. Grizzlick along the line. McAvoy to Bergeron. A glove stop by Luukkonen with Craig Smith in the crease.
I'm not sure what Bergeron had there in terms of where can I put this puck, because that's not where you want to put it. I mean, that's an easy glove save to deny anything else good happening for Luukkonen. It's nice use of the third forward going high in between the two defensemen. Not sure if he had anything. You can see Craig Smith, I don't know if he's trying to draw a penalty. He was trying to win his physical battle to get to the front of the net. Maybe Bergeron was anticipating that.
Krebs gets waved out. Pozo glides in. McAvoy through the slot, nobody home. And the puck slides all the way to the Boston zone. Jake DeBrusk gains speed, gains the line. Going right to goal. Foligno scores his first as a Bruin. 3.5 minutes into the third.
He's been all around it all afternoon. You felt like it was going to happen today. Bruce Cassidy decided to go with Charlie Coyle as the net front present on the last power play for Boston, even though Foligno was around it. But how about this rush by Jake DeBrusk? And DeBrusk rotated back in the offensive zone when Mike Riley pitched down, and Riley let that puck go on purpose, but DeBrusk didn't get there in time. But what did it lead to? A nice running turn with the puck through the neutral zone. Great speed to the outside. None of the Sabres wanted to attack him, so he got easy entry to the offensive zone, attacked the net, and this is what we've seen all afternoon. Rebound opportunities for Boston. Another goal from in tight. Craig Smith was similar. Foligno with his first of the year to get this to a 3-2 game.
Foligno snaps the longest goal drought of his career. Skinner's rifle off the back glass over the goal. Thompson to Tuck, the low angle shot. Kerem's into the stands.
Keep the momentum, Boston. Pastrnak didn't take care of that puck. We get a look at the overhead. There's the drive to the net by DeBrusk. Foligno able to corral that puck, get it into the backhand, which gives you a lot of leverage in tight. And he threw it up top under the crossbar. Huge goal for Foligno individually, but for the Bruins as well. Early in the period, you had to have that believability, Jack, in between the first and second, between the second and third periods, that despite being down 3-1, given the way Buffalo turns the puck over and is not strong defensively, you're still very much in the game.
Bruins ice the puck.
But you don't like this. You don't like this sequence. You got a 3-2. You kind of get right. The crowd into it. Foligno gets a goal. Everybody feels good about it. And then Pastrnak turns the puck over his defensive blue line. Now you have an icing. Stay sharp. Just keep the momentum.
League average when leading after two periods is an 898 points percentage. Buffalo has the 32nd ranked points percentage when leading after two at 708. Craig Smith along the line, around to Marchand, pivots inside. Bergeron couldn't come up with the puck as the next layer. Tuck bounces it all the way to Omark, and a very late whistle.
Well, they wanted the goaltender to play it. You understand that. You just wait for the one-man forecheck to disappear. And I don't think Boston can change it. Didn't that puck come in from outside the red line?
Yes. follow-up back between Hall and Pastrnak. McAvoy's pass does not connect with number 88, and it'll go for icing.
Tomorrow, Women's Hockey East action takes center ice as Providence College faces off against Holy Cross. Don't miss Puck Drop tomorrow afternoon at 4:30 on Nesson Plus, presented by Rockland Trust Bank, where each relationship matters.
The proposal line out there. Will Butcher along the line. Casey Fitzgerald to Olofsson. McAvoy on the block, but the Bruins can't clear. Grizzly indirect. 3-on-2. Taylor Hall with Hall of the net drive. Hall scores! Ba-boom! The Bruins have tied it in the first 5 minutes of the third. 2 goals, 1 minute, 25 seconds apart.
The finish is awesome, but it was the play in the defensive zone that really was the key. It started with a block by McAvoy, where the save was made, a play for Olofsson in the slot, and then the effort by Grizzly to win a puck battle, to force it up the wall, to create the 3-on-2. And then the magic happens, and this is what you want from Taylor Hall. The net drive by Hall allows Hall to hang on to the puck. Hang on to it. Let the debris of bodies clear out in front of you. Keep that puck off your left hip. Toe drag. And what a shot. High glove side. Just inside the post and crossbar to tie the hockey game.
The Bruins are playing with urgency. Frederick gets knocked down by Joki Haru. Thompson. Long diagonal tape to Jeff Skinner. Tosses it across for Tuck. Frederick gets to the red line. Spoons it through the corner. Dahlin against the grain. Hayden. Now Bjork. Omar tried to stop it. Lazar locks up Hayden. Asplund wrists it around. Prow. Asplund swivels off the gong of Omar. Pesek's one-timer. Omar blocks it to the corner. The Bruins again struggling in their own zone. Riley through the corner to Brusk. Can't move the puck forward. Second effort does. Jake DeBrusk speeding up the wing. DeBrusk to Clifton. The bomb and a save by Luukkonen. More than 6 minutes into the third period, the Bruins finally have come alive. 3-3 at TD Garden. Powerful connection presented by Xfinity.
Well, down 3-1 in the third period. Boston thought they had all kinds of opportunities to get right back in this hockey game. They've done just that. You know, the things you're looking for are Foligno to get on the board. He scores a nice goal. He's around it all day long. Emotional release right there on that goal. And then the change of the line combinations. You got a goal earlier in the game from Craig Smith playing with the Bergeron line. And you got a goal from Taylor Hall playing with Hall and Pastrnak. So you're checking a bunch of boxes here, but still plenty of work to do. 3-3 hockey game.
Experience a powerful and secure Wi-Fi connection for all your devices. Xfinity XFi. Can your internet do that? Buffalo ices the puck.
Love that goal by Taylor Hall, Jack, for a lot of reasons. You know, it's off the rush. We talked about Hall in the middle. Can he be a good, effective second-line center? He made the play by making the net drive, running a little interference to allow Taylor Hall to do what he does best, speed through center ice, get into a shooting position, have a shot mentality, and finish. something he talked about, you know, throughout these last 16, 17 days. I need to finish more. I'm getting opportunities. I need to finish. I'm capable. That's my game.
Brett Murray off the end, kick plate, and Omar fields the lively bounce.
And the other thing was because he didn't like what the Bruins were doing after they got to the 3-2. You know, turnovers, icings, or what are you doing? Come on, this is a team that's vulnerable. Stay on the attack, stay sharp. It's execution, make it good. Put some pressure on these guys. So you got to love that Taylor Hall ball for that aspect as well.
Hall breaking a 10-game drought. Foligno, 26. Opposal's shot blocked by Coyle, I believe. Foligno also in the mix. Mike Riley. Coyle gets it away from Olofsson. Carlo off the glass and out of play. Faceoff in the Boston zone.
All season, if you can't see the game broadcast live, it's not a problem. Catch a condensed two-hour version of all Nesson games every game night at midnight with Bruins at 2. Bruins at 2 was presented by your New England Hyundai dealer.
Derek Forbert. Curtis Lazar sweeps it through the corner. Luukkonen right to Lazar. Forbert, the tip try by Nosek off glass and into the netting.
That's a good play by Lazar. You know, he seals off the boards, Jack. He reads it. And he knows Luukkonen's trying to get back. He's trying to hustle. Just get it at the goal. Anything can happen. Good breakout here. Forward, tape to tape to Lazar. Gain the red line. Fundamentals. Luukkonen is going to make a play, but Lazar realizes he's going to go forehand. I'm going to seal off the boards. Throw it right back in the net.
Marchand sweeps it back. Grizzlick to Marchand. Bears off Thompson's check. Whirly bird move. On the boards.
Yeah, that puck just didn't, you know, look like it stuck on him. Just when he had that little half stride to start attacking the net, the puck ended up staying behind Marchand.
Jokke Haru off the boards. Marchand grabs it. Smith on the net drive. Bergeron hesitates. Luukkonen makes the save with Charlie McAvoy on the doorstep. McAvoy with two assists today.
Well, this isn't a turnover in the offensive zone for Boston, but might as well have been because the Bruins get quick re-entry. Four-man attack on the turnover by Buffalo. These are the things you've got to take advantage of. We showed you that turnover package that Boston was unable to be productive off of earlier in the hockey game. Another chance right there.
Pasternak absorbs the hit from Murray. Pasek tips to Hinostroza, the long wrist shot. Omar will take the faceoff in the Boston zone.
You know, you think about teams that have goaltenders that can really handle the puck. It allows defense to really stand up at the blue line and force dump-ins or chip and chases. And right there, I mean, that's a wrist shot from long distance. And, you know, if you have a goaltender that's really confident and lays that puck down and makes a nice little first pass, I mean, makes you think of guys like Marty Brodeur.
Yeah.
And I know it was a different game, and there was a red line in those days, and not as much speed, but the way the Bruins particularly love to defend, denied plays in the neutral zone. But Omar was unsure, so better safe than sorry right now in a 3-3 game.
The puck tipped over the near glass, and the faceoff will be at center. The Hall Pasternak line. Cowboys over the boards. Halla wins the drop. Clifton through Pasternak's stick. Peyton Krebs. Casey Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald again. Fires it toward Omar. He gloves it, and Buffalo gets another attacking zone faceoff. So when the Bruins have had breakdowns in the defensive zone, unable to clear the puck, is there a common thread?
My simple answer to that, Jack, is, you know, when there's been a loose puck, they've been a little slow to react to get to that loose puck. You think of the Skinner goal, or, you know, just the chances that Buffalo's had, just that little bit of rust in terms of, you know, you react to locate the puck, my body position relative to where the possibility of the chance is going to come from. And I'll give you that in terms of not playing NHL games for 16 or 17 days. But again, the focus for me, Jack, is, I think that's the easy part to pick up once they start playing regularly. It's the offense that we're looking for.
McAvoy down the slot, a blocker stop. Lazar couldn't carry the puck past Luukkonen. Skinner gains the line. Tuck sweeps past McAvoy. Nosek interrupts that flow, and the puck slides back to the Buffalo end. Approaching the halfway mark of the third period, the Bruins enter this stanza down by two. Two goals in a minute and 25 by Nick Foligno and Taylor Hall have tied this game. Boston has not led today.
And they had the chance for the lead right here. McAvoy is going to get a really good opportunity. The turnover forced by the Noshik line. McAvoy able to come late, walk right down that high slot. Tried a little misdirection. Selgo glove side, rip it high, short side, blocker side. But a good stop by Luukkonen.
Bergeron to Marchand, the hesitation, and he couldn't get Luukkonen to bite. Marchand to Carlo, the one-timer. Luukkonen makes the stop. That's the release that the Bruins are looking for from Carlo. Smith around through the corner. Murray twists the puck for Cody Eakin. Bounces it to the corner. Omar off the glass. Marchand into the skates of Hinostroza. Riley backhands it to Carlo. Buffalo in the middle of a change. Carlo gains the red line through the corners. Coyle in a battle for the puck. And Kyle Opozo laterally will Butcher. Victor Olofsson and Connor Clifton. Clifton kicks it to the corner. Foligno one-hands it to DeBrusque. Foligno right behind the rush. Forbert closes the bomb, and Luukkonen well outside his crease again. Gave Forbert nothing to shoot at. 9.5 minutes to go. Bruins 3, Sabres 3 at TD Garden. Road Ahead presented by Nissan. Choose Nissan today and get big savings. Shop NissanUSA.com. Whoa, that is a packed schedule. What do you look at? The colored squares or the off days?
I look at the PPDs.
Yeah.
Pittsburgh, Ottawa on that slate. They're talking about these games that need to be made up if they're going to play the full 82. And you know where they're going to try to make those games up, don't you? Did you change your plans for February, Jack?
Yeah. Well, as long as we're at Bruins games, I can do without the deep powder. And it is really deep where I was going to go. Hinostroza across the top of the slot. Yoki Haru, the quick release. Foligno blocks it. Jake DeBrusk on the go. Luukkonen stops him. DeBrusk to Coyle. Good check from behind. And Buffalo clears.
Another big play by Foligno on the shot block. DeBrusk the beneficiary. Got a good shot away, too. High glove side.
Brown pays the price. Clifton finishes his check. Krebs on his off wing, backhands it. The one-timer by Aposo blocked. Pasternak chops it ahead. Halla gains the line, drops to Hall, looks for reinforcement. Pasternak's bomb, a save by Luukkonen. Halla keeps it alive. Krebs, the deft pass to Olofsson. That puck stays in play off the flat panel. Hall spanked away by Butcher. Thompson tape to tape to Tuck. Riley keeps him on the perimeter. Tuck, the hard stop, trying to lose Frederick. Skinner winds up the drive. Loose in front off the save by Ullmark. Casey Fitzgerald against the grain. Thompson twists the wrists. Carlo banks it ahead. No icing. Fitzgerald. Butcher off the boards. McAvoy. Milsik had to tag up. Bruins have tied this game with two goals in less than a minute and a half in the first five of the third period. John Hayden scoops it past the Zamboni doors, goes and gets it against Matt Grizzlick. Bergeron backhands, Marchand takes it down, tough chance. Smith through the corner, Ukko-Pekka Luukkonen back to Rasmus Dahlin, off glass and over the glass. The faceoff will come back to the Buffalo zone.
Turning defense into offense, and this is where Foligno's going to play a nice defensive left leg stop. That allows DeBrusk, with his great speed, to the outside. He gets where he wants. Hashmark tries to go high glove. And then after David Pasternak won a puck back in his own zone, it allowed Halla and Hall to lead the rush. And now Pasternak's that third layer coming late, and he gets the quality scoring chance. Turn defense into offense.
Yoki Haru through the corner. Forward. This is Smith. Dahlin with little space. Smith takes it away. And they're going to call a penalty on Craig Smith. Eakin wants it, Marchand. Clifton and Dahlin paired up, and Dahlin gets one last shove before the linesman steps in.
Yeah, you're kind of hoping that Buffalo crosses a line right here, because the penalty is going to be on this play right here. It's not a stick foul. It's more of a leg infraction.
Boston, number 12, two-minute minor tripping.
Those are the penalties you hate to see. You know, third period, under 7 minutes to go. You feel like you're in control of the hockey game, even though it's 3-3, and you get an offensive zone tripping call, whether you like it or not. The use of the net as your ally to get some separation, and Smith and his zest to create the turnover, goes to the box for a trip.
Krebs wins another faceoff against Bergeron. He's been very successful against Bergeron. 3 for 3.
Yeah, you know, if you're worried about anybody on this power play for the Sabres, you got to know where this guy is right now. Alex Tuck.
Marchand breaking up ice one on four. Finds a seam, stays with it. Tuck to Thompson. Krebs at the line. Forbert, bad luck off of Marchand's skate. Olsen jitterbugs along the line. Krebs through the deadwood. Asplund's shot and a save by Ullmark.
Well, all kinds of stuff happening at ice level. That's a good play right there by Carla to attack. Skinner was calling for some kind of, you know, putting his hand on the puck kind of penalty. And with all those sticks and debris laying all over the ice, the Sabres are able to get an opportunity. Long distance shot relative to scoring areas. Saved by Ullmark.
Butcher to Olofsson. The shot wide. Pozo. Butcher. Kyle Pozo. Back to Will Butcher. Fakes the shot. Olofsson to Pozo. Blocked and cleared by McAvoy.
Good stay-at-home play. Good read by McAvoy to stay there. Seam pass available, but no shooting lane.
Just over half a minute to go in the power play for Buffalo. 3-3 in the third at TD Garden. Pozo. Asplund. Olofsson takes the one touch from Butcher, gives it back. Victor Olofsson's shot, a pop-up rebound. Murray keeps it alive. Olofsson, Butcher, Pozo. Olofsson closes, wide stick side. Butcher, the penalty expires. Smith is back on the ice. Pozo's shot. Caught and dumped out by Ullmark. Pozo from his knees. Brett Murray uses his 6 foot 6 inch frame. Derek Forbert slides the puck to center. Buffalo looking for a quick re-entry. Will Butcher off the end boards. Cody Eakin past Bergeron. Connor Clifton takes it for a skate ahead of Craig Smith.
Yeah, I know nothing happened in terms of bad things for Boston, but might want to remind Linus Ullmark that a lot of goals are scored immediately after power plays.
Hinostroza into Clifton's legs. Marchand runs into Casey Fitzgerald, gets the puck back. Pasternak swoops over the line. Pasternak shot off Fitzgerald's stick and out of play. We're into the Ford F-150 Final Five. 3.5 to go. Threes are wild at TD Garden. Bruins hockey here for good.
Yeah, tail end of a negative sequence. Boston failed to score. Connor Clifton on an open net. Not sure what it counted. We didn't do a deep dive into that play because Craig Smith got a penalty on the goaltender. But then on the ensuing power play, Alex Tuck got a good look at that shot. Top shelf, blocker side. Nice play by Krebs. And then a really nice response by Boston in kind. Always get a good look from that ankle cam at, you know, the pace of play in this National Hockey League today.
These guys are so big and so fast and do things so quickly. It's amazing every single game. Funky bounce off the dasher. Taylor Hall hops on it with Pasternak. Hall back to Grizzlick, manages the puck on the backhand. It tumbles off of Hall's stick. Waves it around. Pasternak, the short pass to Hall. Bangs it up the board. Skinner can't clear. McAvoy tries to get it deep. Skinner. Pass Thompson. Bruins have had better legs than Buffalo in the third. Buffalo playing its third game in 3.5 days. Listen to the crowd at TD Garden. Riley around to Carlo, swings it up the wall. Coyle bumps it ahead to DeBrusque. Mark Pesek. DC Fitzgerald bounces it back to Pesek. Fitzgerald scoops it out to center. Riley right back into the Buffalo zone. Marshawn, the good body move to open up Smith. Fitzgerald takes the bump from Bergeron. Fitzgerald up the cut. Olofsson, Krebs. Back to Olofsson, the shot, and a save by Ullmark with a buck and a half to go.
That's a nice breakout by Buffalo. They're trying to handle the aggressive forecheck by Boston, and Fitzgerald used the middle of the defensive zone to start the breakout. It's something that Buffalo does a lot when they're playing well. And now all of a sudden you get a little speed, a little something off the rush. Olofsson can shoot it. It's a pretty good shot. Good. Right at the Bruin netminder.
Eakin Murray and Hinostroza against the Coyle line. Well, Tomasz Nosek is out there as an extra center in case Coyle gets thrown out. And Eakin gets waved out of the circle. The bomb by Eakin and a brave block by Nosek, who gets up limping. Puck loose. Hinostroza runs into forward's check. Forward through his own crease. Nosek comes back to the puck and ices it. Stroza, well.
Yeah, we're showing you that shot block there by Charlie Coyle after the loss of the faceoff. Whatever it takes to defend in this situation. You want the faceoff win, you don't get it. How do you react? Good shot block. Finish your thought there, Jack.
Yeah, here's Stroza trying to incite Clifton into a confrontation. Clifton didn't bite. Forward. Off the boards, Joki Haru knocks it down. Rasmus Dahlin. Final minute of the third period. Good body position by Connor Clifton. Charlie Coyle to Curtis Lazar goes on Joki Haru. Lazar checked to the ice by Rasmus Dahlin. Just over half a minute to go. McAvoy. Pasternak runs into Krebs. Waves the backhand forward. Pesek. Round through the corner. Less than 20 seconds to go. Mark Pesek. Stops over the line. Bounces it to the end boards. Olofsson to Pesek. Tees it up. Well wide. Fitzgerald kicking it past Opozo, and it's going to be a point apiece, and we'll go to sudden death overtime.
Good third period by Boston. We talked about the need for 4 points this weekend for the Boston Bruins, and with that third period, you've given yourself a chance to do it.
Bruins looking for their first two goals down comeback victory of the season. We'll be back. Why can your internet do that?
The down 3-1 entering the third period. The Bruins needed a really good effort, and they got it. And it started with Foligno, who was the recipient of a great individual rush by Jake DeBrusque. Picked up speed through center ice, beat people to the outside. We talk about his straight-ahead speed. He attacked the net. Rebound chance. Foligno gets inside position. And then after some good defensive effort back in the defensive zone, Grizzly able to force the puck up the wall. That's where Taylor Hall was, 3-on-2. Great net drive by Eric Halla, and a beautiful finish by Taylor Hall. Vintage Taylor Hall. Shot high to the glove side.
Well, Bruce Cassidy reconfigured the lines, and all three lines that are brand new have produced a goal. Marchand to open the overtime. Jeff Skinner. Possession is what it's all about in 3-on-3. Skinner closes. Omark the save. Bergeron the tap to McAvoy. Marchand with McAvoy on the net drive. Throws it through traffic. Marchand chips it back to Coyle. Charlie Coyle gives the Bruins their first two-goal comeback victory of the season. So fitting that it's Charlie Coyle who has performed at least up to expectations all season long, and he was shifted back to what Bruce Cassidy calls his natural third line center position.
Yeah, the need for a second line center, and if it can be done by Eric Hall, then yeah, Charlie Coyle is going to be right where he should be in order to be a dominant player. He's had a good year. He's been productive. He's an important part of what the Bruins do. Bergeron gets off the ice. Coyle's able to step on the ice, so now he's coming late because of the change. And he shoots it across his body back to the glove side. You know, when you watched him play all afternoon, he was the last guy to come out of protocol. Yep. And it looked like it. You know, it looked like, you know, you're going to get effort from him all the time. He's incredibly fit. He's a good player. He's a smart player. He's good in his own zone in order to protect defensively. If you get something from him offensively, like you're getting this year, that's awesome. And he stays with it, and he leaves his fingerprints on a come-from-behind victory for Boston in overtime. Great balance to the Bruins offense here this afternoon.
The Bruins win, presented by New Amsterdam Vodka. In life, you gotta find your wins, and when you do, celebrate them.